I named it STAC and Dr. Prakash named it Kir Pat. So, intra-articular fractures. Just brief about intra-articular fractures. What are the why are the controversies? This is from article. Loss of height, increase in weight, increase in length, disruption of the posterior facet of the subtalar joint, and apparent bulk of the lateral wall. Now, anatomic reduction of the subtalar joint is the main goal. Restoration of heel shape and alignment. Reconstruction of the Achilles tendon lever arm. That means you have to pull the calcaneum to down. Otherwise, if calcaneum height is decreased, lever action of endo-Achilles will work. And reduction of the lateral bulk to preventing impingement. Now, half of the complication is a subfibular impingement in the calcaneum fracture. Reduction, stable fixation to allow early movement. Now, why early movement is required in calcaneum fracture? And by reconstruction of calcaneum, preservation of normal tibio talar relationship. So these are the goals. Now Roy Sanders, who is the classification is named after him from Florida. Now even he has designed Timex new plate calcaneum titanium. Even he has got 8% failure rate. And that's why he commented that I can fix the bone exactly right on the money and the damn thing still gives the person a bad result. So this is another foot surgeon. So all are related to bone. If you see that is if it is related to bone only, which impinges soft tissue around it. And this is the morphology, tongue depressed and tongue depressed. So these are the mode of primary and secondary. This is the EL maneuver and reduction of depressed fragment. These are the X-ray parameters. Now, how this frame works? Because of these two ligaments, intrastus PCL and ACL, anterior cross ligament and cervical ligament, anterior capsular ligament, sorry. Now, if you distract the capsula, this fragment will come up on its own because this is sinus tarsi. And if you remove the talus, you will see the behind that is cadaveric view. Now, how I come to this point, because when I see the reduction technique, this is the historical things. Single point distraction, people are using to reduce the calcaneum. This is two point distraction. So, they are using tibia and they are using calcaneum. So, different techniques. This is three point distraction. So, this is main theme of my subtalar frame. They are using cuboid, they are using calcaneum, they are using talar only. Now, while operating, if you are able to retain this reduction by this distraction, then if you are keeping this reduction stable by this frame only, then it will give very good results. So this is another reduction method, that is triangular at talar apex, and this is triangular at calcaneal apex. Both axes are different. Now reduction with transverseous STAC frame, this is my main thing. How to put wire and how to do it. Now, there are fixators from orthofix on calcaneum. This is orthofix, calcaneum X-fix. Now, why I am promoting that this is static, this is not dynamic. And this is dynamic. Now, in subtalar arthrosis or subtalar arthritis, now primary treatment where I work at Florida, they usually distract the joint for 6 weeks and they get very good result, and then they can reverse the subtalar or any arthritic pattern from right from ankle. Even in Perthes they are doing hip distraction, in knee they are doing KJD, that is knee joint distraction, in ankle they are doing so distraction capsular ligamentous axis at subtalar joint leads to cartilage regeneration, calcaneal parametric reduction, and main thing is subfibular impingement because peroneal is moving. It is not adherent due to ankle movement freedom. And dynamic tension, if you see the rings, if you plantar flex, calcaneum will be pulled down. Plantar ligament pull and elastic recoil of the artery wire. So I am mixing artery wire along with it. While other static frame, it is only static, only distraction which leads to stiffness, and they have got pins technique, that is cantilever mechanics, and tibial pin ankle movement block. So this is another modified orthopics they are using. Now they have started using
calcaneum only. This is another with Taylor B. Now, he Ilizarov of calcaneum. I'm not the first to talk about it, but a biomechanical evaluation to optimize the configuration of hinge external fixator for the primary treatment in this article. The finding that hinge fixator allows 20 degree of ankle movement without alteration to the rotation axis and suggest that this type of external fixator can be used in all types of calcaneal fracture regardless of the soft tissue damage. That is foot ankle surgery, American College of Foot and Level of Clinical Evidence and Journal of Foot and Ankle Surgery. So another friend, Dr. Mario, who is using Miros, he is a very good friend of mine. He has got this technique. That is the button and wire. It is equivalent to JESS type of things. This is Russian technique. Now my drawer, my guru, Dr. Dror Paley, he was using arc wire, but for varus and valgus correction only. In calcaneal fracture. This is arc wire concept. This is olive wire connection of varus and valgus. This is reduction with transversus, as I this slide has been shown previously. Now, palpable landmarks, that is calcaneum and ankle. Tibial nerve, flexor hallucis longus are the structure at risk. And this is the step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. Initially, I was using cross wiring talus. Now, I have started using parallel wire in talus. So, step 1, that is talus wire. Step 2 is calcaneous wire. This is 45 degree I have started. And then I started using arc wire instead of this. So step 1, first talus olive wire. Dr. Prakash has already told about that posterior venous direction to avoid malunary dendrite capture. Second, talus olive wire direct from anterior medial to posterior medial. But now I am using only parallel construct. So, parallel to the foot plate and perpendicular to the foot axis, longitudinal axis. Five-head ring, cuboid, sometimes I add. In two cases I have had. In this demonstration case I haven't added cuboid wire, but it is helpful. And calcaneus, as we already know, medial from calcaneus, which is up and down, and pulling this fragment down. This plate should be at the heel level, foot plate. In 45 degree or distraction rod, and now I am using distraction rod. Dr. Yunus has started using two rods, right?
Four rods.
So, reduce elevation, posterior facet, and pass smooth wire. Yes, some techniques are there. Reduce elevation, somebody was asking me. But you can pass suspendicular wire in fragment, plain wire. And beware that hammer on the medial side because of neurovascular bundle. So this is step 1. This is step 2. We are using tibial pin. This is from website. And this is elevation of the fragment. This is final frame. And about talus wire complication, I have studied about talus blood circulation also from the literature, and I passed my wire safety. These are another supplementation technique to keep the fragment elevated.
So high
width coronal anchor is maintained, and this is my case. I don't know what to do. This is alcoholic patient, suicide from third floor, platelet count, and I was forced to think upon it. This is a CT scan slide, sagittal, coronal, and this is talus wire. It is a plain wire, not olive. And this is my construct. This is arc wire, which is reducing. This is subtentaculum wire, which is compresses with the distal fragment. So this wire is the heart of this fixation.
It is a three-hole band. You put wire over here, 1, 2, 3. It makes 30 degree angle
free.
And every, you see the orthogonal mounting of the frame and air, it's lateral also. And this is the video is not working.
I showed it.
You showed it. So this is the reduction.
This is the immediate postdoc. This is main thing. This is what I mean. Your this subtalar distraction is the theme of this. It will help you a lot to prevent subtalar arthrosis. This is the result after 6 months. No doubt I haven't able to maintain the height of maintenance with this angle. If I have pulled a wire more, it would have been better. But patient is walking without any pain, without any, this is united. So controlled dynamization of the fracture is likely to stimulate bone healing, while lateral motion is likely to minimize the development of adhesion. That is the main impingement and pathological contracture within the capsular ligament and apparatus above the calcaneus. Distraction of arthroplasty with motion at joint fracture, cartilage regenerate, mimics yield near cartilage inner. And anatomical histological surface, newer application study by Dr. Himansu and Dr. Prakash also, allow early weight bearing without Dr. Himansu allowing weight bearing after 10 days. And heel width and bulgus and plantigrade foot promotes combination healing in adjusted position and absorption gliding tendinous surface. So perineus is gliding all the way. So it will not adhere and it will not impede in between subfibular space. So drawbacks in study, no bone model, cadaveric, no biomechanic. Long-term follow-up is not there, but it is a low volume, 3 cases from my side, weight-bearing advice, clear question, and no CT parametric comparison with other options. Thank you.
One minute.
Sorry?
Yes.